My dear students, today's topic is about coal and petroleum. Coal and petroleum, these are also natural resources, but they are non-renewable resources. So they are very important as they are one of the source of energy for industries as well as for domestic use. Our energy needs are largely dependent on coal and petroleum reserves. Now, coal and petroleum, these both fossil fuels are formed by degradation of biomass of plants and animals respectively. They were buried deep into the earth millions of years ago. We obtain coal from the coal mines dug into the earth, and petroleum is obtained from the oil wells deep into the earth. At the present rate of consumption, coal will last for about 200 years. And the petroleum reserves on earth will last for only just 40 years. So once this get exhausted, it will be not available for us in the near future because their formation is very, very slow and cannot be replenished in the near future. Now, coal is used in various ways. It's a combustible fossil that is buried deep in the earth, used for domestic and industrial purposes like production of electricity in thermal power plants, used for the manufacture of coke. Its gasification and liquefaction yields fuel gas and synthetic petrols. Other than this, there are enormous other uses of coal. Like that, the petroleum is also a dark colored liquid fuel extracted from the earth, both on land and from the sea as crude oil. Its fractional distillation yields petrol, diesel, kerosene, fuel oil, lubricating oil, paraffin wax, and many other products. There are various uses of petroleum, like the LPG is used for cooking and heating. Petrol and diesel are used for running various vehicles, including aeroplanes. Lubricating oils provide lubrication to machineries. Paraffin wax is used in candles, vaselines, etc. Asphalt, it is used in carpeting roads, and there are numerous other uses of this petroleum. But we have to remember that pollution is one of the cause due to the burning of this fossil fuel. The fossil fuel are made up of carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen and sulfur. So on burning, they produce carbon dioxide, oxides of sulfur, oxides of nitrogen and carbon monoxide. And all these gases are very, very dangerous and have enormous health issues caused by these gases. Thus, conservation of fossil fuel is very, very important. So, in order to conserve coal and petroleum, we have to limit their use. So, how can we do it? Here, I am going to discuss few of the points that you can opt to reduce the use of these fossil fuels. That is, using of pressure cookers for cooking that save fuel like kerosene and LPG. We can even use biogas in the rural areas, using of CFL lamps and fluorescent tubes instead of bulbs, using staircase instead of lift. For short distance, you can use bicycle instead of using your vehicles. Use public transport instead of using your own vehicle. You can use energy efficient electrical appliances to save electricity. Even in this winter, you can wear an extra sweater instead of using a heater. So, my dear students, it was all about coal and petroleum, the fossil fuels that are formed over millions of years by degradation of biomass of plants and animals. We have to think about their conservation as these fossil fuels are non-renewable resources. Hope you have enjoyed the video and understood the topic. Thanks for watching the video.